Hey guys, Frank here. Today I want to talk about BMSs. I know that there's a lot of people who have a lot of different opinions on BMSs. Which ones are good ones? Which ones are bad ones? Should you use them? Should you not use them? I am under the opinion that you don't have to use them, and that you could, and there's different types and different ways to use BMSs. But for me and some of the stuff that I'm doing currently, I'm going to be using some BMSs. And they're really simple ones. They're not anything elaborate. I know there's some really nice Batrium BMS systems out there. The type of battery packs that I'm building, I cannot seem to figure out if Batrium will actually support them or not, because I'm actually putting all of my batteries into a full cell pack, where the ones that I've seen, they'll do it based on the long mons are actually attaching to each cell set. So it would be equivalent to one cell, a 4.2 volt cell, or 3.7 nominal. And I would like to use something like that I could actually go back to a monitoring system where I could hook it to a computer and actually see the results and see where things are as far as my batteries and where my cells are and how they're balanced and which ones are low and which ones are high and if I'm having any issues. But at this point, I'm just gonna have to stick with the good old fashioned smaller units. So here I have a few BMSs that these here came in used. These, I got some 36 volt packs, battery packs, and these came with those battery packs. That's why they're all cut off on their ends here. This, I believe, is an 8S unit, and I haven't tore it all the way down, but looking at the circuitry on the back, I would be surprised if it's more than 20 amps. I'm thinking it's probably going to be, 15 to 20 amps. It might be 30, but I don't know. I don't know for sure because I haven't looked into it. But these are examples of some. This here, everything that's on this one is in languages I'm not sure of, but you can see the circuitry there, and this is also an 8S BMS. So they have different sizes, and these came like that. Ones that I've been using, that I've used a little bit, is this this unit here, which is for my 4S systems. And this BMS is only rated at 30 amps, so it's not something I can put a lot of amps through it. So I use it for smaller things like my battery pack here. You can see the BMS in here on the case. So this here is one that I have built up for carrying around. I can carry this thing around, and I have power with me just about wherever I want to go. And right now it's at 13.7, so it needs a good charge. But you can see the BMS in here, and this has come in handy because when I first built this, I had issues, and I wanted to share this with you. I had it tied to my heat blanket. If you look back on this video up here, I had a heat blanket, and I was using it one night, and I went to sleep, and I woke up the next morning, and this was dead, which was known, but I plugged it in, and I couldn't get any voltage out of it. It was zero. It was nothing. And it turns out that one of the cell banks in there got over-discharged, and it ran those cells right down to zero, and I could not revive them. They just died. The rest of the cells were fine, but that one cell pack in there was dead. And so that's when I decided to start using a BMS. And so I added this BMS, and I have not had an issue since. When it gets down to being too far discharged for any of these cells, it shuts off. This also has balancing on it, so it keeps the cells, the four cell packs, in sync with each other so that I don't lose that. So this is something to consider if you, especially on a small kit like this, it's very helpful to be able to have the ability to control the amount of voltage in and out and keeping the cells balanced. So that's kind of my take on BMSs. I think that some of the things that you should look for when you're trying to find a BMS is, I think it's important to have a battery balance feature. There are a lot of them out there that actually don't state that they're balanced. They'll just say they're battery management systems. And so what they'll have is they'll have a charge discharge shutoff point, and that's really all that's there. And having that balance, I think, is important, especially when you get into some of these cell sets, you know, your 4S, 6S, 8S, 13S, when I go to my Powerwall stuff, you know, it's gonna play a difference in how those cells stay balanced and stay functioning. There are there is some stuff I want to play with, and I'm not sure how I'm going to get to it. And that is when I'd like to take and do like either a Raspberry Pi or a something along those lines, one of those smaller computer modules, and actually build out my own BMS system to manage my Powerwall stuff. Something very similar to Batrium, but more of a DIY thing, because I want to save some money and try something out. So I may be doing that. I'll leave another link here to another video that I watched where a guy's actually doing it. He's actually got a Raspberry, I think it's Raspberry Pi, that he's using to balance out his systems. So I may be wrong. Don't quote me on that. It's been a couple weeks since I've actually watched the video, but it is something that I want to do in regards to BMS. So a couple other points on BMS. This pack here has a lot of amps in it. This is a large amp system. So I needed to get one that's higher. These only do 30 amps. 12 volts at 30 amps is not a lot of throughput. I know that if I were to even try to bring this up, because if you think each cell, so let's look at capacity, C, okay? In 18650s, the capacity of the cell is C. So if you have a 2000 milliamp cell, that's a 2 amp cell, what you're going to run into is C is 2 amps, meaning I only want to run, because these are a lot of times these are harvested cells, I only want to run 1C out of those. So I only want to run a maximum of 2 amps. And if I have 100 and some odd cells here, technically I could run 100 amps, because that's 1C per cell if I'm at, you know, two amps per, you know, that's closer to actually 200 amps that I could run out of this pack. But my inverter that I'm using only wants to get around 100 amps. So I don't want to over push it, or I know it's going to have its own shutoff, but what I'm going to do is try to control that by using the BMS. So I put 100 amp BMS on there to allow for flow, mainly just to protect the cells. This is another breaking point where you don't want to overdo it. Now then, one last point on BMSs. There are different types of batteries. You have LiPo, you have lithium-ion, so on and so forth. Be sure that when you get a BMS that it supports lithium-ion, and if nothing else, strive to find it that supports 18650 lithium ions run different. They have different voltages. So if you just go and buy a BMS, because a BMS is a BMS, right? Well, it's not. If you get one that doesn't support lithium ion and it's for LiPo, you might hurt the cells, or you'll actually hurt the BMS itself. More than likely, you'll hurt the cells. So my recommendation is make sure that when you're getting a BMS, specifically for 18650 cells, that it supports 18650 lithium ion. That will help protect your cells, and it's something you need to do. A lot of you are harvesting cells, so they need to be, you need to make sure that you're using the correct BMS instead of just trying to make it happen. Those are some things, and they're not very expensive. Well, this one was a little bit more. I think I paid like $15 for this one, but this one, these here are like $3 or $4. They're not really a whole lot. And these I got free because I harvested them off of a thing, but I don't have anything that's 36 volts. So I guess I could give these away, right? All right, so that's my take on BMSs. Maybe that'll change over time. Please leave your comments below. If you find this interesting, please subscribe, and I will get back to any comments you have about BMSs or batteries in general. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.